Installing Linux on a USB stick is no longer difficult today. But what if you don't want to change the boot record on your local hard drive and want to use the Linux stick on any PCs and notebooks? There are different ways to do this, especially for GPT UEFI, and I'll show you the easiest one here. Pro tip: using a fast USB stick is a good idea. Using a fast M.2 drive in a USB enclosure is even better. This is the case with the M.2 drive that I used in my video about stable diffusion under Linux with AMD GPU, link above. As usual, I use the fast forward in tedious places, but I'll show you the complete process in all details up to the successful booting. I'll also point out difficult steps in good time. I promise. So the secret of the simplest installation of a Linux system on a USB stick for GPT UEFI is the new installer for Ubuntu desktop. Unless the Ubuntu LTS version does not include this new installer, so we have to use the latest non-LTS version. Well, currently at the time of making this video, there is a small challenge. This button is grayed out, there is some translation issue, but I have downloaded one version before and we will use this for the next steps. Nevertheless, when you can see this video here, I'm sure this will be available, and make sure to use this download button here and do not download the legacy desktop installer, as this will not do the trick. So again, use the regular standard download button here and download the ISO. In order to create a bootable version of the ISO with the Ubuntu installer, we will use Rufus. And regarding the downloadable versions, I prefer the portable one. Okay, it's downloaded, so let's just start. Okay, it was on the second screen. As you can see, I have used the simple 16GB USB stick. That's more than good enough. Now let's select the ISO image. As I said, I've already downloaded it. And yeah, target system is GPT. The rest can stay as it is. Okay, let's start. Write an ISO image mode, that is okay. Yeah, data will be destroyed, yeah, that's normal. But nevertheless, just recheck that you use the right stick and do not format one of your hard drives. Rufus is working now, so we just fast forward. Well, copying the files has been finished, and so we have successfully prepared our USB stick containing the Ubuntu desktop installer. We will use this stick in order to create a runnable version of Ubuntu desktop on our target USB stick. In the next steps, we will boot from the modified USB stick, and there is no chance to use a screen capturing program, so I have to record the screen with my camera and apologize for the lower quality. Now you have to boot into your BIOS by pressing the corresponding key. For my PC, it is the delete key, sometimes it's the escape key, sometimes something like F6, F9, F12. You simply have to try. As you can see, we are in the MSI AMI BIOS, that's the one from my PC, and there you have two different options in order to make sure to boot from the created Ubuntu boot stick. In the settings, we have the boot entry, and here we could just change the sequence of the boot devices. In the top here is the hard disk, and we could move the USB key to the top boot, and then as it is in the top, it would simply boot by using the USB stick. As you can see, the boot mode is already UEFI. If this is not the case on your PC, then you have to switch to UEFI. Legacy or CSM is wrong. For booting, we will use a different way for the ease of use. In the save and exit section, there is a boot override. Most BIOS do provide such a boot override, and there you can simply select the USB stick. So you can see here is the Windows Boot Manager, here is our USB stick, and by just clicking it, the boot is overrided and we start with the USB stick. Simply select try or install Ubuntu. Don't get confused if there are warnings, and it would not stop the boot process. So as you can see, we are already booting here. As I've selected quite a slow USB stick, don't be confused if it takes a moment. And here we are already in the Ubuntu desktop for our installation. Simply select the language. We could already do the installation of Ubuntu, but I will select try Ubuntu because before starting the installation, I will change the display settings in order to increase the scale and have a bigger font for you. Okay, now the letters are big enough to show you the installation. There seems to be quite a bug here. Okay. Choose your language. Keyboard layout, yeah. Forgive me, but as I am in Germany, I will select the German layout. That's more easy for me. I have already a wired connection here. If you do not have a wired connection, simply connect to Wi-Fi. Well, we will do a minimal installation, as that's the fastest way. If you would like to have a normal installation, choose the corresponding point here. Additionally, I will not install third-party software and such things. That can be done later. That point is quite important because... Oh, that was interesting. That point here is quite important, as this is something we do not want. We want to have an GPT UEFI USB stick, which is able to be used both with, for example, your desktop computer and your notebook. So it's important not to install the boot manager alongside Windows, so not on your hard drive. What we want to do is directly install it on the USB stick, and especially make sure that the boot manager, the group boot manager of Ubuntu, is installed on the USB stick. That's done by manual partitioning. So now I insert the USB stick into the PC. Okay, say next. Okay, this one here is the Windows systems. Be sure not to touch it. Some people even suggest to unplug all your hard drives in order not to overwrite them. But I think here it's quite easy. 4 terabytes, that's the Windows system. Here these are 2 more internal hard disks of my system. These here are, well, from an USB device, from an adapter. So that's zero, that's not what we want. And this here is the stick I have just plugged in. I can see it because of the size. If you have a hard disk of same size, then you might be more careful and maybe just unplug it in order not to overwrite. Nevertheless, we select this device here. Well, simply create a new partition table so the whole device will be erased. Now we will create the required partitions one by one. Frankly speaking, you do not need all of these partitions, but I think for performance reasons it's better to use them all. So we will create first of all the root partition. Well, usually say that's quite big here, but if you want to install some more software, that's okay for such a large USB device. If you have a smaller USB stick, just take 10 to 20 gigabytes. So, as you can see, automatically there is another partition created for the boot EFI. That is important for groups or for the GPT UEFI booting. Oh, free space. What else is required? We choose swap. Swap is for swapping a memory. The theory says have at least half the size of your RAM. So as I have 32 gigabytes, we take 16. Usually that is good enough. Okay, that's for swap. Then we need home partition. For the home partition, I will just choose 120. I'll tell you why in a second. So that's our home partition. And for the rest, I will just cannot be selected. Leave it unformatted. The reason is usually I have another partition formatted in exfat-fuse. By using this file system, it is usable both for Windows as well as Linux. It can include large files, small files. It has a decent performance, and I use it for exchanging data between my main Windows system and the Linux system on a stick. Most important point left is selecting the device for the bootloader installation. So make sure to select your USB stick as the device for the bootloader. The option to select the boot device here is the main difference to the Ubuntu LTS version and is the main reason why we have selected this Ubuntu version. Okay, so everything is prepared. We say next. Just check if everything is as expected. That's my USB stick. We will have one partition for root, another one for booting. We have a swap partition and we have a partition for home. That's where we usually store the most data. And this one here, you can simply use Windows in order to format this here to exfat-fuse, and then you can just access it both with Windows and Linux. If you do not like it, then omit this partition and add the space to your home partition. Now we install. Unless the installation crashed, and that was always the case when I increased the font size for better readability. So the only chance was to use the zoom of my camera in order to show you the most important points. Again, this resulted in a lower picture quality, I apologize. We select our time zone and we create our account with well, in this case, very short name and short password. The installation starts and again we fast forward. Finally, the installation has finished and we can reboot again. In order to select the boot device, we enter the BIOS again. But as an alternative, for my PC, it would have been possible to simply press F11 in order to select the boot menu directly. I'm quite sure for your PC something similar exists, you just have to find out. In the Linux boot menu, we could have just pressed return and that would have been okay. But at least for the first run, I prefer selecting the kernel directly, because by doing it that way, there is at least an output of loading the kernel and the RAM disk. For some reason, loading the kernel and RAM disk took several minutes. That doesn't have to be the case for you, but don't stop right away. Nevertheless, I have a tip at the end of the video, and if nothing helps, it's a good idea to wait until an LTS version uses the new desktop installer. After some time, loading the kernel and RAM disk finally finished and our fresh installation of Ubuntu was successfully started. Last thing to show you here is the installation of the XFS driver. You find the command in the description below too. If the video helped you, I would be happy about a like or a comment. By the way, I had some challenges creating this video and suspected Ubuntu 23.04. In fact, it was probably the USB stick which has now completely failed. If you experience very long loading times, I have included a useful link in the description below.